שלום, we're a little bit after Hanukkah and we are very close to the Christian holiday. It is a lot of similarity between these two holidays, the Jewish one and the non-Jewish one. The main thing about the Christian holiday that it is a light that is less and less light. It means the day become more and more short, and then it become again longer and longer. It's like the relationship between
towards the solstice, winter solstice.
Yeah, no, but it's less and less. The day is more and more and more
shorter.
Until you get to the more short day in the year, what originally was the 25th December when the calendar was Juliani calendar. Today is the calendar is Gregorian, so it came in the 21, the shortest, the short day in the year. But how in Hanukkah we have something similar? In Hanukkah, really, we have two opinions about how we light the candle. You know that one of the main machloket in our sages is machloket.
Debate? Or
machloket, it means
dispute.
Dispute, it's like
argument,
not agree, between the house of Shammai and the house of Hillel. So, of course, אלו ואלו דברי אלוקים חיים, it's all the word of God. Even one says so and one says completely something else. This is both the word of God. About Hanukkah, בית שמאי says that we start with 8 candles. After we go less and less.
Decrease.
Like the Baptist John said about him, says that now I'm going to go less and less, and Jesus will go up and up. All right, so
more and more.
We can say that we have here two lights, that one have to do with the days that become more and more short. So Shammai says that we should start with 8 candles, after 7, after 6, after 5, until we get to 1 candle. And Beit Hillel said, no, we start with 1, and we go up, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, etc. All right, so one of the idea of my rabbi is to connect the two opinions together and make a holiday of 15 days. If we start with Beit Shammai, after we increase 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, so the one we count, it's like 8 day plus 7 day. So it's less and less light, like in the day of supposed to be the 25th of December, it's the minimum light, and after this it again the light is more and more light. So
until the solstice and after the solstice of winter.
Yes, okay, so we call it Zman HaHipuch HaChorfi, you know, in the Paganese time, this used to be the birth of the god of the sun or whatever. In all Paganese, this it was in many Paganese, in this day of 25 December, the god born again, died, born again, you know, there are many different story about this. But even it's the root of this is pagan, it is the idea that it is a holy spark in this concept of the light going down and after going up. And this we can see, if we put together the two opinions about Hanukkah, so then this day, if we have this day will be Tet Tevet, the nine of the month of Tevet. If there will be 30 days in the month of Kislev, this will be in 9 Tevet. If not, this will be in 10 Tevet, the last day. 9 Tevet is a day that, according to the tradition, Judaism, Jesus born. It's interesting that when they check the calendar, that was 2,000 years ago. So the 1st of January or the 25th of January happened in 9 of Tevet. Right, so by according to the Jewish tradition, this is the day when Jesus is born. What is came to be the last day. It's like the maximum of the light, or after you get to the maximum of the light.
Of the Hanukkah.
Altogether here you have 71 candles. That is a Yimach Shmo in order number. In order number. What is the Chai Bahem? The Chai Bahem. You will live by them. It's expression that appear 3 times in the Bible, if I'm not wrong. So all the commandment is to live with them. Not to die with them, it's to live with them. All right, so this equals 71. If I do opposite, I start with the idea of Bet Hillel, and from 8, I come back to Bet Shammai, so then we will have 64 candles altogether, what is 8 square.
From 1 to 8 and from...
From 8, back.
To 1.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 7, 6. Really, it's, if we make a connection of these two opinions, we have 15 days. I mean, we have the 8 and we have the 7. We have two concepts that have to do with this holiday of Hanukkah, the 7 and the 8. Where we have appearance of concept of 7 and 8, in the book of Micha, we talk about that God will send us against Ashur, 7 shepherds and 8 prince of men. Shiv'a v'akemoti lahem, shiv'a ro'im u'shmona nesichei adam. So it is a 7 and the 8. It is ro'im, is shepherd, and Nesichei Adam. There are 7 like this, and there are 8 Nesichei Adam. 8, of course, is the concept of Chen. Chet. It's like the 4 candles of Hanukkah. Chet, 8 Nesichei Adam, prince of men. Now, what is the difference between the concept of the shepherd and the concept of the prince? It's like the concept of a light that I can receive it inside. It's like opening me. That's something that I understand. It becomes part of me. And it is always a surround light. Always have to do with the mother, so it's like a surround light. 8, it's like above creation. Right? Like the mother that we call it the 8 firmament, הרקיע התמינה. Okay, so it's a concept of seven chapter and
seven
shepherds and eight we talk about Ro'e and we talk about Nasir. That is the acronym of Ner, candle, Ner. Also each candle represents the connection between.
Nasir is a prince.
He's a prince. Somebody that is a prince, somebody that is a shepherd, it's like somebody that teach me Torah. Somebody that is a priest, it's like somebody that I worship his personality. It's not his knowledge what he teach me, it's just,
like
wow.
The king, the melech,
like,
the Kohen.
Like a rabbi, wow, what a barb, what a face. It's like to be impressed of somebody, it's mean to receive a surround life from a person. I just saw him and wow, what impress. I saw his personality and then I, not in holiness, he can become Avodah Zarah, can become worship the personality instead of worship of the knowledge will be important. What he teach me, I put the knowledge inside and I just make a big deal from the personality. This is basically what happened with Jesus, but really Jesus is a shepherd, like he said,
shepherd, yeah.
He's a shepherd. Even we don't see it, he belongs, is more of a shepherd of a prince.
Then.
But what they make from him, it means have to do with the number seven, more of have to do with the number eight. And when we talk about the 13 tribute of mercy, attribute of mercy, the seven one is the emet and true. Emet is always the male one. After is notzer chesed is the eight one, what has the acronym of chen, notzer chesed. The eight one, have to do with always the hand, have to do with eight. So the emet, it's what we call the light of the face of God. We call it Sha Neorim, the 370 Sha. What is the basic, most important letter of Yeshua? Yes? If I write Yeshua, the most important letter is the Shin and the Ein.
Why they are the most important?
Because Yud and Vav, it's letters that are not root letters. It's letters that falling and add easily. It's not all the letter Hem and Tiv, it's letters that you can add it to many, many words and they are not root letter. Okay? So Yud and Vav is part of this letter that is not really root letter. So of course, the seven here is the secret of Jesus, is the light of the face, and the face, we say that the two have face to here and to here, panim lechan ulechan. All right, so it's like the two cheeks of Jesus. All right, it's like the two personality, Esav and Yaakov, these two eyes, hapanim. Panim equal enayim, same gimetia. Face equal eyes. Okay, so this call the face.
And this
cheeks. But we call it hapanim, the face. Panim. Enayim. Same gimetia. Alright, so this is concept we talk in the past. I don't want to get too complicated with this. Anyway, we have in the 7-1 is the concept of Shah. Shah have to do with Yeshuot. We call this elevation Yeshua, Yeshuat Hashem Keref Ein. Yeshuot ve-Nechamot. It's another kind of celebration. Nechamot have to do with Chen. So it's like two kind of Geula. It's Geula that call Yeshua, and it's Geula that call Nechama, Yeshuot ve-Nechamot. It's two words that go always together in many of the prayer we say every day. Yeshuot ve-Nechamot, Yeshuot ve-Nechamot, in any, in different way.
What is the difference exactly between them?
This, the seven has to do with light that go inside. Mm-hmm. Eight is a surround light.
So Yeshua and...
Yeshua have to do with the concept of the seven.
Okay.
Even if the Son of God, Son always have to do with the concept of seven, is the Son.
Right.
Is Yaakov. Yitzchak is the mother. How much you call Yaakov? Yaakov equal 7 times the name of God. How much equal Yitzchak? 8 times the name of God. And how much equal Yosef? 6 times the name of God. 156 is 6 times the name of God. 182 is 7 times the name of God. 208 is 8 times the name of God. All right, so this is a concept of
shepherd,
and this is a concept of prince. It's like he receives his kingdom from his father. Right.
And six is.
And Yosef is a six. Now, when we talk about, in the past we talk about Nerama Ravi, they used to light the six in the menorah in the temple. There was only 7 candles. But we light the sixth one after the seven. It means the sixth one is the eighth one. Like Jesus said about the beast, about the head of the beast, about the 7 kings. He says there was kings, there are not anymore, there was 5 kings. After, there are 2 more. The 2 more, after Yoshiyahu is a 5 kings, is Ahaz, Chizkiyahu, Menashe, Amon, and Yoshiyahu. 5 kings. After Yoshiyahu came Yehoyakim. He's a son. He's a son of Yoshiyahu. And after came Yehoyachin. But really, there are few generations of kings that belong to, there are few brothers that belong to the generation of Yehoyakim, and part of them, like Tzidkiyahu, came after Yehoyachin. It's like Zerach is a little bit of Zerach before Peretz, only his end. It's like a small, really, kingdom. It's not really a revelation of this generation. After came Yehoyachin, Yehoyachin is like the donkey. After the mule came Yehoyachin. And only after Yehoyachin is like the priest, it will be a real revelation of the eighth one, what is really from the seven. He is the sixth one. Okay, so after Shema Yisrael, we say the 7 words that we say is Chaviv. אמת ויציב ונכון is אהוב, lovely, חביב, this is a 6-1, this is a 7-1, נחמד, cute, have to do with חן. מה, מם דלת איקואל, איקואל ילד. It's like the חן, the grass of a kid. Alright, this has to do with Yitzchak, this has to do with the concept of the prince. This has to do the seven with Yaakov, with the shepherd. This has to do Ha'uv with the six. But really, Yosef Yitzchak supposed to be, it's like the same personality. Even Yosef is Avraham and Yitzchak is David. How much equal these three words together have the acronym of Achon. Achon is Adam, Chava, Nachash. V'chanuti et asher Achon. I will give Chanina, Chen, grass. To who I will give Chanina. V'chanuti et asher Achon. Achon is the acronym of Adam, Chava. Even she is a woman, she have to do the concept of Chava have to do always with the concept of David the king. Like we explain. Adam have always to do with the concept of Yosef, the first man. We did Gematriot with this in the past. If you do a triangle of Aleph, Dalet, Mem, all the letters from Aleph to Aleph, from Aleph to Dalet, from Aleph to Mem equal Yosef. Alright? And our sages, all kol ha-shvi'im chavivin, all the seven are chaviv. Chaviv, it's like, it's another way to say lovely. And nechmad is cute. Okay.